Next on the list, we have interesting news regarding Clubhouse and this announcement that they're going to be into funding 50 pilot audio shows for creators, which I think is a sign that the app is dying. Whenever you see a new service, app, platform push out all these new initiatives that kind of favor the creatives and answer some of the questions and criticisms that are levied at the app prior, like, you know, a lot of people were basically complaining in the early days of Clubhouse when a lot of the urban community were on there basically making it what it was and creating loads of viral moments. People are complaining that, oh, this company will be, though, I think a lot of people that had early conversations with Clubhouse, they were being very stingy in terms of sharing any sort of like revenue splits or whatever they could in terms of, you know, just giving people bags in terms of getting the eyes and ears on the app. And then of course, as time has gone on and the usage of the app overall has kind of gone down and the hype is basically stagnated, they've now decided that they maybe do need these influencers and creators who are the backbone of this app, especially because it's exclusive and no one can get on it unless you have a friend that's on it already. Now they're suddenly deciding to launch this funding of the 50 pilot audio shows on there. But in my opinion, I think it's a little bit too late. I always said from the very beginning that I thought Clubhouse was way overvalued when the people were talking about it being $1 billion app, that when it was going to be listed on when it was going to go public in the first time, or think of people investing in it. I remember there was an article around it being valued at somewhere close to $1 billion or over $1 billion, which was absolutely insane. I thought part of the reason why it was very successful, similar to what's that other one called, is it Garage or something, what's it called, I don't know, but it was another voice conferencing sort of app that was very popular in the beginning of lockdown. But most of it had to do with the fact that we were basically, you know, confined to our apartments, to our homes, to our family houses, to our bedrooms, to our dorms for the most part of this lockdown, and we didn't really have any other way to entertain ourselves apart from, you know, exchanging, you know, voice memos on Instagram or whatnot, and maybe chatting, you know, if we were allowed on the app such as Clubhouse. And in the moment the world started to open, these apps started to dwindle in terms of their ability to hold our attention and the fact that, you know, they're all in real time, you can't listen to anything on demand and all that malarkey. But by and large, it only really succeeded because we're at home. And I was just wondering, how are they going to scale this if we then decide to reopen the world? Like, what happens then to Clubhouse? Like, who's going to be using it as well? That's going to be another introduction too. And in general, I just didn't enjoy the experience. I thought, you know, there's already enough social media platforms out there. If you do come along, you just have to do something really interesting in terms of what TikTok are doing, in terms of the content that's on there, right? You don't really find TikTok content anywhere else on the internet. It just exists on that one app, so it's fairly unique in that way. And then of course, the feature itself is easily copied, right? And that's why you've got Twitter, have got their spaces. Facebook is going to launch something like Clubhouse, which is going to be insanely popular if you compare it to what Clubhouse will be able to do, especially when you think of all the mums and dads and family members that you have on Facebook who are always ranting and raving about whatever nonsense subject they're talking about. Imagine they're given the ability to host these audio chat rooms on Facebook with their groups and their pages that they're liking and stuff. It's going to be insanely popular on stuff like that. So essentially, those other companies have basically removed any sort of unique selling point from Clubhouse, which initially held. They were very resistant to kind of giving people bags in terms of them bringing eyes and attention to the brand, so now they're having to play catch up. So it says here, Clubhouse is funding the creation of 50 audio shows made by creators on its platform. The concepts include everything from an interview series with Taryn Southern, which I don't know who that is, to a pair of shows discussing the cultural hairstyles of a game show called Serial Killer Speed Dating. Oh, so cringe. The participants will each get $5,000 per month stipend for 3 months, plus gear and creative support to help them create the series. The goal is to develop and pilot each show over the next 3 months. If shows take off, this possibility, Clubhouse will sign some of them to a long-term deal. This is the first round of creators to benefit from the Clubhouse Accelerator program, which it says will help support new voices and tools and resources to unlock their creativity in the platform. Clubhouse says that it's not taking any ownership of the content shows and the creative develop. The goal is to ensure that the creators themselves enjoy complete control and ownership of their creative output. So essentially, they're creating their own podcasting network, which is, you know, wild to think how it started. Clubhouse announced its accelerator program back in March ahead of its service first anniversary. Its popularity with the Silicon Valley venture capitalist crowd has led to the large amount of early buzz around the service, as arguably disproportionate to the mainstream popularity. For example, as of writing, you still need an invite to sign up to Clubhouse, and it doesn't have an Android app, despite that the recent funding valued the company at $4 billion, which is wild to think that, and I think it's grossly overvalued. And then you look at this headline from 9to5Mac: Clubhouse downloads plummet to 900,000 in April as competition grows. It says Clubhouse quickly became a huge success in a year, with reaching over 8 million downloads in the iOS app in February alone, 8 million downloads. Most of it was intrigue, most of it was FOMO, most of it was the need to be included. You know, you feel like you're not invited in this exclusive club, but 8 million downloads in the month of February for iOS only is wild. A news report claims that the app registered around 900,000 downloads in April and dropping from its peak of 9.6 million downloads 3 months ago. According to the Sensor Tower research shared with Business Insider, Clubhouse has 922,000 downloads globally in April 2021. This represents a 66% drop from the 2.7 million downloads in March and becomes even more considerable when compared to 9.6 million downloads of Clubhouse had in February. Sensor Tower data suggests that the user retention of Clubhouse is still strong, which means the majority of users who download it still have the app installed, which is not really interesting because I still have it installed on mine, but I'd never ever open it. However, the significant drop in the number of downloads is worrying for the company, as it means that fewer potential users as interested in the social network. The company has tried to stay relevant by introducing a new feature to monetize live chats and even a program to help content creators, but that doesn't seem to be enough to ease the competition. In recent months, companies like Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn — I didn't know LinkedIn had one, come on, that's a wrap. If LinkedIn launch a Clubhouse alternative, it's a wrap, because you know, if there's anyone that likes to hear the sound of their own voice, it's people on LinkedIn. Telegram and even Spotify have introduced their live audio platforms that do basically the same thing. I did Spotify have one as well? I don't know. Okay, cool. Twitter Pacific has been doing well with its audio platform called Twitter Spaces. Twitter finally and available became widely available today to users on both iOS and Android. Meanwhile, Clubhouse remains a pretty much iPhone only app, as Android beta version was only introduced earlier today. Despite the company being valued at $1 billion in January and looking for new investors, the future of Clubhouse is now unclear, as it should be. But again, maybe they might just carve a niche out for themselves, similar to Snapchat. Snapchat was always on the ropes. People were always kind of counting Snapchat out, you know, every year, and they seem to always kind of turn it around. So maybe they could do the same thing. But I've always said from the very beginning, I thought it was overvalued, and now I'm basically being proven right. I think when the world reopens, people are going to completely forget about the app and just want to do anything but stay on a fucking smartphone for a prolonged period of the day. They're going to want to go back outside, you know, get wasted, hang out with people, swap saliva, and do all that stuff. So good luck to Clubhouse. Good luck to them. Good luck.